So what's up YouTube? In this video, we're going to talk about five things that you can do right now to get better at fighters for any skill level, for the beginners all the way to the pros. Let's do it.
Choose your fight time.
Cool. All right. Let's get into it. So, five things you can do right now to get better fighting games. We're going to talk about all of five of these. The first one is two ways to use replays. So, that's the first thing we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about using replays to pull tech from other people. And we're going to talk about using replays to better yourself as well. We're going to talk about making a tech checklist. So, we actually want to make a list of every... We'll get to it. We're going to have a real talk about consistency. So, we're going to talk about how important consistency is for getting better at the game. Not dropping these combos and actually making sure that you know exactly what you're doing at every time. And we're going to talk about team problem solving. So this is where we get into getting into groups and getting friends that can help you solve problems that you're having in the game and writing them down. We'll get to it. And goal-oriented sets. We're going to make sure we always have a goal. So let's get to it. Step one is two ways to use replays. So I'm actually going to give you an example here. Let me pull up. So right here, I got Twitter pulled up. And you don't have to use Twitter. I also use, you'll see I use Twitch and I look at people's VODs, or we'll look at YouTube and we'll do searches, or also a lot of the Japanese players are in this like Mildom. So right here I got Goichi and I got Fenrich, and basically what we'll do, the first way to use replays is you actually want to go through here and just step by step watch them until you see something that you don't know. So the first time you see something that you don't know how to do, or that you didn't know about, or that gives you an idea, you want to take it back to the lab and you want to use that to either recreate it or come up with your own way to implement it and use way. And this is the first way we're going to use replays. And you can do this in-game replays too by following other people. But the quickest and fastest way to do it is to do it like this. Especially, I like YouTube the most, because on YouTube, let's say we're watching, you know what, let's go over to like HOC. So let's say we're looking at a match, right? And the reason why I like YouTube is, let's say we really like, we really like this Android 17 setup right here. We just happen to find this. We know that we press back, that's gonna go back 5 seconds, right? And we can go back and see this again. And then we can pause it and then go frame by frame using period or using comma. So using this, using YouTube and using your replays is a really cool way and really quick way to find tech online and to try to immediately implement it into your gameplay. Let's talk about the next way we can use replays. So basically what we want to do here is the exact same thing, except for now we are instead of trying to find tech, we are trying to solve our own problems. So we want to find something in the game. I'm going to go to my own replays and I'm going to pick a replay, preferably one that you lose. So I try to find one that I did not win. Will be a little tricky. Oh, here we go. I lost this one. Now in here, because you can't replay, what I advise you do as soon as you get into the replay is you actually pause it. You press A to pause, and then you can show the buttons and you can go by frame. You see the left button will let you go frame by frame. So even though you can't like go back, if you really don't like, oh, okay, what's going on here? Okay, we look at their inputs. So Gohan jump back. Let's see what's going to happen. And you can really go step by step and see what people are actually doing. And because you can actually see people's inputs, you'll really know for sure if like you miss something and how they're doing it, right? So if you want to know like their option selects and you just don't know, you can't tell what they're doing because they're getting a different option every time, you can see what their actual inputs are, so you can really get that. But the best way to use this is to look at your own gameplay. So because I'm looking at my own here, I'm gonna look for a mistake that I made, or something, a mistake that I made, or something that I could have done better. So I probably could have punished that, but we live, we learn. So we weren't able to get out of the beam in time. It's something we could work on. Jumping beams. Let's see if I can find a better example. But basically, this is what we do as pros. We go in here and we analyze our own replays and we analyze other people's stuff and we pull everything we can. literally anything and everything we can. And we'll always be learning. Always be learning. You don't want to... The person, at the end of the day, the person who has the most knowledge is the person that's going to win. But this should give you a good idea. But basically what we do is we analyze our own replays. And we'll go in here, we'll make a list. And then we'll go back to the lab. And we'll be like, oh, I need to work on this. Oh, I need to work on this. Oh, I need to work on this. And then you go to the lab and you work on it until you get better at it. And if you need to, we'll get help from people that can help us, which will be later on in the discussion. All right. Part two. Make a tech checklist. So we're going to talk about making a tech checklist. So what is a tech checklist? What we want to do is have a list of things that we need, a list of tools, like a tool set. And I'll show you mine. And then we want to fill it out per character, preferably with videos. So character tech checklist. So if you can see here, I got this Word document here called character tech checklist. And in my checklist, if I have a new character I'm learning, here's the things that I want to know. I want to know all a character's burst options in neutral. So basically that's any option that is 20 to 24 frames, preferably 20 or less, right? So for example, burst options, just a real quick explanation of what a burst option is in case you don't know. So basically, when we talk about burst options, we're talking about things that are not reactable, right? So usually the human reaction time is about 16 frames, but you also need to like have some kind of cue or some kind of tell, right? So the harder the tell, the longer it's gonna take. So even though like 6M is 24 frames, the tell isn't immediate. Like it's kind of soon, but it's not immediate, right? And basically my point is anything 20 or 24 frames or so, so like this right here is 21 frames, is unreactable. So if I record and I do this and I turn him to, let me have another one, slot 8 that is block, right? I'm gonna turn that on random and we're gonna turn block up more. So I don't know when he's gonna do it. Repeat randomly. All right, now I'm gonna hit play and I'm gonna try to jump when he does it. Oh, I tried. Oh, I got hit. Yeah, see? So it's unreactable. So basically any option that's 20 frames or less. So over here, baby, for example, this right here is 20 frames. This right here, 19 frames. So this is a pretty fast burst option. Basically, the first thing you want to know is your character's burst option. All right, so let me get back into the list here. So we want to know all their burst options. I want to know, I want a mid-screen to corner combo with one assist, another assist, two assists, and zero assist. Same thing with corner to corner, side switch, a corner combo. And basically, in all these combos, I want to have two versions also. So I want to have a lag version, which is an easier version. And then the optimal version that I can do whenever, right? So sometimes you just like, you can sacrifice a little less meter gain and a little less damage to make sure you're not going to drop your combo because you're having a bad match. You know what I mean? And the last thing you want to do is go for that optimal combo because it's the only one you know when there's like 7 frames of lag. So it's good to have two versions, an optimal one and a lag version. So my Vanish confirms, Vanish extension, Super Dash, Happy Birthday. So these are all the combos that I want, right? And then I was like, okay, so now here's the block strings that I want. I want a block string that beats guard cancel, a block string that beats reflect, a block string that beats double reflect, so on and so forth. So basically, you want to have your own tech checklist of everything that you want to have. This is a sliding knockdown. So these are, I want to have options for all of these. And ideally, when I'm doing this, I want to have a multi-option and a hard read situation. So I want to have one that will cover... Well, option select as many options as possible, right? So let's say I think they're going to uptech, but I don't know. They might do something else. Then I might go for like uptech, but I want to cover as many other options as possible as well, right? But let's say I really, really know they're going to uptech. Well, I want to have a separate option for that, a hard read option. So if I really, really know you're going to uptech, I can really take advantage of it. You know what I mean? Because you'd hate if anytime you know what's going to happen, you should be rewarded for it. Hard knockdown, reflect switch out, DP. So these are all things that I want to have setups to beat, right? So if the opponent reflect switch out, I want to have a setup for that. And ideally, it's going to cover, I'll have an option that recovers this and everything else This is stuff I need for my character when I'm zero on block. So zero on block is like after 6M. So I want to know my best class string. I want to be able to have something to do if they jump, something to do if they like to backdash, something they do if they like to block. Vanish on advantage, vanish on disadvantage, super dash. Basically, you get the point. You want to have your own checklist of everything you want for your character, right? And then you want to have, ideally, you can write those options down, but ideally, you can actually record them and put them into clips and put them all in a folder on your computer. And that way you can be like, oh yeah, what was this? I can just go look at it, right? So, that's the character tech checklist. Number two, moving on. Number three, real talk. Let's have a real talk about consistency, okay? All of you guys who are dropping your combos and setups and stuff online, the reason why this is happening is for one of two reasons. The first reason is because you haven't practiced enough to never drop it. So when you practice things, you're supposed to practice until you can't get it wrong. Instead of a lot of people practice until they can do it right once, and then they go try to do it online, and then they don't do it right, and so they keep practicing not doing it right, and they build bad habits. But what you should do, and here's what I'm telling you, is you should always do whatever you're practicing on 10 times in a row before you take it into a ranked match, okay? Because if you don't, you could be building bad habits, right? And the second reason why people drop their combos and setups and stuff, why they have a hard time with consistency, the second reason why people drop their combos is because they want to do the hard stuff all the time, right? Finally, I remember. So that they always want to do the most optimal thing, even in like 10 frames of delay, right? You have to realize that sometimes you have to just be real with it and realize that you're human, and sometimes the optimal combo is too hard to do 10 times in a row in practice mode, or you're at very least not ready for it. So if you are one of these people who are dropping your combos or dropping your setups or dropping whatever, it's for one of these two reasons. Yeah, man. Like sometimes you have to just bite the bullet and get a little less damage or a little less meter gain if it means that you're not going to drop your combo. And that's what it is. Like, that doesn't mean that you should stop practicing the advanced combo. It just means that you shouldn't do the advanced combo online until you can do it 10 times in a row. And if you can't do it 10 times in a row, then you're just going to be building bad habits. Because when you go to practice your combo, you're going to do it wrong, and you're going to do it wrong, and you're going to do it wrong, and you're not going to know why you're doing it wrong because you're not practicing it. You're just doing it online. And then you're eventually going to do it sometimes, and you might do it half the time, but I promise you, you're going to progress so much slower than if you would have just... And if you would have just practiced more or done an easier combo. And that's the way it is. You notice a lot of these pro players, they don't do the hard combo every time. They just don't. You'll see Goichi, like even Fenrich, who always does like the hard combos. He doesn't do it every time. Sometimes he goes for the easy combo. So you have to make the decision, especially online. You got to realize that sometimes you just have to bite the bullet and go for the easier combo. Number four, problem solving. All right, team problem solving. So there are many resources to get individuals to help you. So one of the main reasons why I started this whole coaching thing is because videos and tech and Twitter stuff and none of this stuff will teach you what you need to be working on right now. And it's not going to give you the experience that somebody who's teaching you has. You know what I mean? It's just like trying to learn guitar. If you go to a guitar teacher, you're gonna progress a lot faster, and you're gonna know what you should be working on at any given time, right? The way I learned guitar was I practiced a song and then I just played it, and then I practiced a new song and I just played it, and it probably wasn't the best way to learn. And eventually I used all these bits and knowledges of songs that I've learned to play and put them together to freestyle and stuff, but it took a long time, and I feel like I would have been a lot faster if I would have had a teacher. So the reason why team problem solving helps is because it's kind of like coaching, but not quite. It's better than just having somebody. It's better than just doing it yourself, right? So if you can present what you have to like our Discord community, link in the description, or exclamation Discord if you want, or maybe you can post it on Twitter, right, and ask for comments, or maybe you just have a group of friends that you like to hang out with and talk to, that you can be like, hey, can we do some, you know, some block training, or hey, can we do some neutral training, right, or hey, check this out, do you, let's go to practice mode, watch me do this, can you think, help me think of a way we can make this better, right? So Double L is my training partner, and we literally do this all the time. I will have on one screen, I'll have my game, and on the other screen, I'll have his game, and we'll watch each other play in practice mode. Or we'll get on Parsec, and we'll just do practice mode together. And we do this stuff all the time. So having a partner, having a training partner, or having a group of individuals that you can hang out with, chat with, show your stuff to, will really help you get better. So that's number four. And number five, we're talking about goal-oriented sets. So a lot of times people just get on and they just immediately start hit ranked match. They don't have any kind of goal, and they just, their only goal is to win. And I'm telling you, the best way to get better is to actually have like a specific thing you're trying to accomplish in your game, right? So if you're playing like a tournament match or whatever, then I got you, right? But listen, if you say beforehand, all right, this match, the thing I'm working on is this specific thing. Just like earlier, I was working on the specific 6M and Baby B, or Super Dash and Baby B. That's a specific thing that I was working on while I was doing my matches. So while I'm doing my matches online, I have a goal, right? And having that goal, always having that goal, will always help you get better, right? So not only are you being like, okay, this is what I'm working on, so you can practice getting that consistency down, right? But you can also practice doing it against a real person. And as you slowly implement individual strategies with specific goals in mind, and not just getting online and playing ranked over and over without any kind of goals or mindsets or learning ever, then you're gonna get better. So these are the five things again. So the first way was, two ways to use replays. We talked about replays. We talked about making a tech checklist. I show you my specific tech checklist. We talked about consistency and two ways you can get more consistent, and team problem solving a few ways using Discord or Twitter or just like groups. You can find people who are also interested in helping you, and you help them in exchange. And then goal-oriented sets, making sure you always, when you're going online to play these games, making sure you have an actual objective and you're trying to accomplish a goal. And that is the five ways. Oh, wait, it didn't work. Why didn't it work? Outro. All right, there we go. We got to play the outro. So, and that was the five ways to get better at fighters. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Oh shit, you got the same headphones I got. Oh shit, yeah, I do. Thanks for us. Yeah, man, these are cool. I like these a lot. I'm actually going to be doing a video about, like,